Sex Medusa is a movie from Hong Kong. It is the type of film that you really have to go into without any expectations. And going into the movie without any expectations is a tough thing to ask audiences to do, because with a title like Sex Medusa, it's hard to not automatically categorize the film right off the bat. For starters, the movie certainly doesn't showcase the Legend of Medusa like most people would be expecting. The film begins with a group of scientists that are inside of a sewer conducting an investigation. They find a large group of eggs that they attempt to destroy. However, one of the eggs is not destroyed and hatches into a snake creature and then quickly morphs into a woman. The woman tries to adapt to her surroundings in order to find food and shelter. A man eventually finds the woman and attempts to take care of her, but as he introduces her to other people and time goes on, suspicion begins to arise about who this woman really is. This isn't a monster that turns men into stone. The woman here is half snake, half human, but the movie isn't interested in retelling the story of a legend. Instead, it's telling its own story about a monster that has characteristics of a person and a snake. I by no means think it is a bad story, but it's not a story of men scared to look into the eyes of a monster and then being turned into stone like the Legend of Medusa. So that's just something to be aware of right away. The film also doesn't make a very good horror movie. The suspense, the thrilling moments, the violence, the creepy atmosphere, the dread, just none of that is present here. The half-snake, half-woman doesn't show much of her true form until the very end, and when this moment does come, it certainly isn't very terrifying. If anything, it's a little funny to see what this woman looks like when she is taking her revenge. This isn't a monster movie where the monster is not shown until the very end, and then when it is shown, the build-up and suspense makes it worth it. The reveal here isn't anything scary, and really, when audiences get to this point, it probably won't be a surprise that the monster isn't scary, because the film makes it very obvious early on that it is trying to create a character to watch on screen, not a monster to be scared of. This woman is half human, half snake, but there is a big attempt here to show her develop countless human feelings and characteristics as the movie progresses. It's also important to note as well that even though the movie does have the word sex in the title, this isn't an erotic film. Sex scenes are not the focus here. There is intercourse in the movie at some point, but it is not shown in detail. The main character is supposed to be pretty, and throughout the movie, her beauty is mentioned, but the way her character develops is what is on display here, and that is the driving force behind the movie, and that's what keeps the movie moving forward. So taking into consideration that this film doesn't have the characteristics of a typical monster movie, and it also isn't terrifying or scary, like a horror movie, and on top of that, it isn't erotic like most people would be led to believe by the title, it's easy to wonder what's left here exactly. The story is what's left here, and the story of the film keeps things moving along, but it's tough because if people aren't going into the film expecting a story, then viewers may not give it the attention it deserves and just dismiss it altogether. The story here is by no means complex, it isn't hard to follow and it doesn't contain many twists, but at the same time, I didn't find myself bored with it. It kept my attention, and while I was never overly surprised by the events that were occurring on screen, it was still a decent experience to watch the story unfold. I just find that it's not the type of movie that really lends itself well to repeat viewings though either. There are some movies out there that really benefit from repeat viewings because there are things that people will typically notice the second or third time they watch the movie that they didn't notice the first time. I don't feel like Sex Medusa really has that. It has a story that I wasn't bored with, but it also isn't complex enough to give me incentive to come back to it multiple times. The Region 1 DVD release of Sex Medusa comes from Tokyo Shock. Unfortunately, the DVD doesn't have any behind the scenes featurettes or interviews with the director, crew, or cast members. The DVD simply contains the movie itself, as well as trailers for other Tokyo Shock releases. It's also disappointing that the DVD only contains the English language version of the film. There is no option to watch it in its original language with English subtitles. I know the lack of language and subtitle options will really upset many people who enjoy watching Asian movies in particular. Sex Medusa isn't a movie that I can recommend to many people. I'm fairly certain that it will disappoint most people who attempt to give it a shot. It contains a story that was somewhat interesting, but is ultimately forgettable. Every now and then I find myself in the mood to watch an old Asian movie. I enjoy seeing how older films differ from movies that are produced today. Sex Medusa isn't a terrible choice if you want to watch an older movie from Hong Kong. It's decent, but nothing really stands out about it, and that unfortunately itself is a huge flaw. People who are interested in the film's concept can give the movie a shot, but for people who want to watch an Asian horror film, there are much better options out there to choose from, both old and new.